All right, okay, Shalom Rastafari. This is Wendell Malonzo with the Land of Cheetah Society. It's been a while since we've done this, but we've been focusing on guiding I and I brothers and sisters in Latin America, or those of us that have been dispersed into geographical locations that happen to have been colonized or conquered by those of a Spanish tongue, and for which reason speak Spanish, you know. And so, okay, this will be we hope a short message, because we actually gotta go out and do stuff. But we heard Wendell Yadun's message concerning, you know, how we're trying to come together and keep forward in the movement in doing a little bit too much too soon is kind of like what we got out of that reasoning, that we kind of got we're under the impression that we're not inspiring trust to our elder brother, in the sense that maybe we're not completely grounded in what is necessary for us to be grounded in. And so, and actually we second that motion. We completely agree with that. So this video in particular is concerning how to support the Lion of Judah Society, how to, at least this will be our opinion, on a suggestion, counsel on what to do when one wants to help in forwarding in furthering the progress of our lives as Rastafari and Ethiopia's progress. So this will be kind of like we'll be honest. We'll put forth what we would recommend that ones would do whenever one feels that I want to contribute. And it's a lot easier than we think, but still it's very hard. And we deal with this problem every day. That's why we're sure that our message is right on as far as what is necessary of Rastafari to go forward. And so, being that for the Sabbath or Senbet of June 20th, Friday evening, June 20th to Saturday evening, June 21st, we think, I'm not too sure, 2014, Torah portion reading or Ritnabab, a reading for that Senbet is Torah portion number 39. So that would be ordinances of the law. Give us 1 second here. Torah portion number 39, titled Yehigu Tezas Yehnu, Hebrew Bekhukotai, and then we have if I'm not mistaken, somewhere to the effect of somewhere along the lines of in the English the ordinances of the law. And actually we'll go ahead and just might as well double check that so that we don't mislead anyone as far as the proper title of the study that we're about to utilize to strengthen our counsel concerning what can we do when we feel that urge. And I'm sure that all that are true and faithful are on a daily basis are just eager to want to help in the forward movement that is Rastafari, which is truth, which is the eventual, you know, like the healing of the nations, healing of the world to all the sufferings, right? So it is, this is the ordinance of the law. That's the title for this Shabbat reading. And so we're going to utilize the main focus of, it's the main focus of this Shabbat reading, which is, excuse me, we're we got carried away. So we're going to utilize the main focus of this Shabbat reading for portion number 39 to strengthen and to, and as kind of like a, as our backbone to support the counsel that we're about to bring forth as to what to do when ones want to contribute and the best way to go about it. So the main focus, the highlight of this Shabbat reading is Moses is instructed to raise a serpent on a pool, a brass serpent on the pool, and those that are that have been bit by the fiery serpents and look upon this this brass serpent on the pool, on the cross, that in looking upon it, they would surely live. And so actually, might as well, you know, go straight to that so that we don't have this, you know, bring this forth half, like, in not fully, right? So, it's chapter 21. Okay, we're just going to read the whole thing. We're just going to read from verse 5 to, might as well read to verse 9. So it says, and the people spake against God and against Moses, wherefore have ye brought us up out of Egypt to die in the wilderness? For there is no bread, neither is there water, and our soul loatheth this light bread. And the Lord sent fiery serpents among the people, and they bit the people, and much people of Israel died. Therefore the people came to Moses and said, we have sinned, for we have spoken against the Lord and against thee. Pray to the Lord that he take away the serpents from us. And Moses prayed for the people. And so it reads, and the Lord said to Moses, make thee a fire serpent, and set it upon a pole. And it shall come to pass that everyone that is bitten, when he looketh upon it, shall live. And Moses made a serpent of brass, and put it upon a pole. And it came to pass that if a serpent had bitten any man, when he beheld the serpent of brass, he lived. And so now that it's, we give thanks to the Almighty, the Most High God, Jah Rastafari, because if we had not read this, we would not have gotten a clear understanding of how to go about this, how to bring forth this message. We can't recall exactly what the uploaded video on behalf of our brother Yadon was titled or named, but it's pretty much like what we read here. It's like there's fiery serpents hissing or you know, speaking what they speak into the ears of I and I people, and it's like we're tired of it. It's like our people having received the bite from the serpent is kind of like want to do too much too soon, and bring forth this attitude against the Most High and against I and I, which is to say Moses. And you know, it's like you know, why'd you bring us out here? Why are we still out here? You know, there's no bread, there's no water, and this light bread, this light work, that's like we want to do more. We want to keep it going. You know, it's like we want to do. You know, like Rasiatinoferri say oftentimes. And so it's like, it's the same thing. It's the same thing that we got from that video. We apologize for not being able to bring to mind the title of the actual video, so that ones could be sure to know exactly what I'm talking about. But it's just recently been uploaded. It had to do with Wendem Yadon went into how the society, how it went from a fraternal order to a full-blown society, and how, you know, that whole reason. And so, like, so continuing, it's like we're at that point where some of us are like, you know, we're tired of this light bread. You know, we want to go forward. And so Jah sends fiery serpents. The main focus, it wasn't even our intention to go that deep into it, but that far into it, but what we're trying to say here is that the main message is that serpent upon the pole, that brass serpent upon the pole, is Yeshua crucified. It's the shadow of things to come. It's the fulfillment is Jesus Christos, Yeshua HaMashiach, upon the pool. The living sacrifice, sacrificing himself to do the will of the Almighty. And so what we're trying to kind of like share with all our family, with our brothers and sisters that are willing to receive, is that we must sacrifice the flesh. You know, since the beginning in the garden, it was that serpent that kind of bit us so that we would incline to the fleshy, to surrender our will that is to be holy to the Most High. That is to say that our whole purpose is to keep the will and do the will of I and I, God and Father. And so by being subjected to the bite of the serpent, we were enticed into doing our own will and not the will of the Most High whom created I and I. And so from thence we have the fallen man. And so we're going to utilize this parable, this kind of like word picture, to kind of like use it as an example to explain how we are in that point, and we can utilize this to do what we should be doing to help the ministry and to help the forward movement the correct way, doing the will of I and I, God and Father, Haile Selassie I, Rastafari, in Jesus Christos. And so what it is that self-sacrifice, sacrificing the enticement of the flesh, which is represented by the serpent, and being aligned upon the cross, upon the pole, upright, you know, upright in the manner of which man is to be, and not on the ground and stuff like that. But excuse me, we kind of lost our thought, but going forward, so sacrificing our personal, our like vain, fleshy will and our desires, set that aside, hang it up on the cross, and do the will of the Most High. Keep straight in His way, in His path. And we will recommend that whenever anyone wants to contribute to the society and do what is necessary for the furthering of I and I progress as a people, as the people of the Most High, then it's to think about all the things you want to do and don't do them. Hold on 1 second. Okay, everything you want to do, think about it. List it if you have to. Write it down if you have to. And then don't do it. And then, you know, if you have a good memory, do it in your mind. If you have to write it down, write it down. But then think of all the things that you don't want to do for the Most High. And surely that which is required of us is within that list. And we're not saying this because we're just preaching like if we're something out of this world and stuff like that, but it's because personally we go through this every single day. Every single day we know what we got to do. We know that we got to study and read the Bible, but that's the last thing we want to do. Even and we enjoy it, but still we ain't gonna lie to no one. That serpent is in our nature, and it'll do everything in its power to keep I and I from doing what is necessary. And so we know that is what is required of us, and still we fight it, but we're conscious of it, and we do not allow ourselves to remain subjected. You know, we'll if we happen to be doing some you know, picking up and getting ready, but like doing the shower thing and the eating, you know, we're thinking you gotta go study, and you gotta read, you gotta study, you know, like. But then we know that, but still our flesh kind of like lags it or delays it, and then we get other ideas. So why don't you draw, why don't you go out and do this, why don't you play some music? And sometimes we do fall victims to it, and we always get disappointed because we're not the kind of people that do good with music, except only in the spirit of the Most High, in Jesus Christos, when we can play, because it's not even us. So then we get disappointed because we know already that we're not musicians. We only do that when it's Christ in us that is seeking to express himself in that manner. And so, but sometimes we don't become subjected to it, and we just get down to studying. But what we're trying to say is that it don't matter like how much we like studying and stuff like that. Our flesh will not want us to do that, because that is exactly what we are supposed to be doing. So when that, we recommend personally that whenever one wants to contribute and help the further movement and progress of the society and of Rastafari, study the Bible and learn for yourself the ways to serve the Almighty, and inevitably you will learn the ways to serve your fellow brothers and sisters within the human community. These are the words of His Majesty Most High Ali Selassie. And so this is what we recommend, honestly, and we might not, a lot of people, you know, within our family may not appreciate what we're about to say, but nothing else is as important as this. Ain't no repatriation gonna do nothing if this is not done. I mean, it's not to say that repatriation is not a must, but it's more important to study and to read. That is what is going to make everything possible. I mean, don't try to go about this and do this through your own power. You must know that the Most High in Jesus Christos will make all these things possible whenever it is necessary for them to be possible. I and I don't got to do nothing. I and I just got to learn and study and keep straight in His way. Sacrifice our wills and trying to go out there and do this and do that when what we should be doing is perfecting His temple, you know, building ourselves. And so that is, everything else is a waste of time. These things, I'm not saying, I and I is not saying that we don't have to go through the paperwork, so, you know, name changes and the citizenships and the, you know, the takeover of Ethiopia or the replacing into proper hands to whom Ethiopia belongs, you know, that whole movement. We ain't against that. It's only that in Christ, we ain't got to worry about that, because Jah, being the Almighty Creator of all things, He's got the handle of all things, and so He will set it up so that we don't got to do nothing, because the world are His servants, and whenever it's His will that this be done, we being in His will, knowing His will, by studying His will day and night, like nonstop, with all our strength, heart, might, and all them things, all we got to do is sit back and watch the things be made manifest. For example, I don't need to be worrying about how am I going to get there, when I know that Jah Almighty, being the ruler of all men, can just send forward whomever he need to send forward and put me in a situation where I'm going to get a free ride. Whether it be because I happen to be the only person that can do something that this individual needs for him to get there, on his plane, on his boat, whatever, or be it that the Most High send a newly faithful individual that happens to own a yacht, and he's you know, the Most High sends him, and he's willing to drive me out there up to Africa. See, that's really how it works. And if I'm wrong, you know, then if ones can educate me in the way that what I'm saying is wrong, then I'll clearly accept it and I'll take it back, you know. And my bad for bringing forth this attitude, but I'm sure and I'm confident that this is not wrong. In Christ, we don't carry a heavy, you know, we're not heavily yoked. Everything's easy. You just gotta have faith and know that these things will come about. Now, we're not trying to discourage taking initiative, personal initiative, and going about these things. That is a requirement. But when it's interfering with what is our principal responsibility, which is to know that which we are supposed to be, then it becomes a problem. And so, you know, slowly but surely, and if what I've suggested happens not to be made manifest, then we too ourselves would have been, you know, little by little have been doing those taking those small steps to do it like independently without divine assistance, and you know, kind of like to put it that way. But but the main focus is to study, and so this is the message that we bring. Nothing helps like this. Nothing helps like studying. Like, I mean, there's no possible way that we can explain this in fullness, how powerful and how true what we're trying to bring forth is. Stay in Jah, stay in His Christ, in Jesus, and all things will be made manifest with them. You know, you'll just be walking down the street and you'll bump into some person that happens to be an expert at doing all the paperwork. And because you just happen to rub him the right way, he might just be completely willing to do all this stuff for you for free. See, that's the way we see Jah work with us, because to him, as to us, it benefit not humanity that we kind of be distracted with other things. And so, you know, Jah will make it so that we do not have to be distracted all the time and focus on what is truly necessary, and that is to study. And it might seem like a light bread, but ain't no heavier bread than the word of the Most High, let me tell you. So there's no excuse, and we daily struggle with this. We're not trying to pretend like we perfected this, but because we do, we are confident and we are you know, strong in sharing this message, because it's true. We always want to do all kinds of things except for the thing that we know we should be doing. And so, I mean, let's be that self-sacrifice. And so, let's keep on doing the extra curriculum, they say, activities that we're into, but let us not allow that to kind of like be a priority when what we should be doing is learning. It's everything just comes to be when we study the scriptures. His Majesty, we're gonna end with this, and we're gonna say it once more. He says during the Lutheran Christmas special hour interview, study the Bible for yourself. Learn for yourself the ways to serve the Almighty Creator that is good. In doing so, you will inevitably find the way to serve your fellow brothers and sisters within the human community. So it's not me saying this, it's the Most High. And how do we study the Bible for ourselves? We study the Bible. And how do we learn to serve God for ourselves? We study the Bible. For the Bible tells us the way of which we are to conduct ourselves within this life experience. And so in doing so, it'll just come how to, but actually the studying is serving your fellow brothers and sisters within the community. Studying the Bible is actually contributing to the society of His Imperial Majesty in more ways that one can ever imagine. You just have to have faith, because it's not seen doesn't mean it's not a reality. We are quick to desire things that are seen, but that's the way of the serpent. That's being tempted of the flesh, things that don't profit, you know, the spiritual, the spirit, anything. But if we focus on that which is both, it'll be made manifest quick. And we mean flesh in a real fleshy book, but full of spirit. And you know, in that coming to union, it'll be given to us how to go about it. And then the scriptures tell us everything. It shows us the way that we are expected to behave ourselves within this world, and just knowing how to do that will be the greatest help. There's no greater help than acting correctly and being that example to all others within this human community. I mean, there ain't no way to go about it. So, Torah portion number 39, the ordinances of the law, and the main topic that we chose to present is Moses working up a brass fiery serpent, hanging it upon a cross, upon a pole, and those that were bitten by the serpent, whomever of them would of Israel would look to the brass serpent upon the pool would surely live. And so let us live by, you know, sacrificing the flesh and doing the will of the Spirit, which is the will of the Most High, which is love, and Jah is love. And if we love Jah, rather by way that we have been loved first of Him, then we would have loved our brothers and sisters automatically, because we would then know the way to love each other. And being taught of Him, being loved first of Him, then we would be known the way of which to go about in loving our brothers and sisters. But without the Word, we can't do nothing. The power, I and I power, Rastafari power, is in the Word. And so the Word will manipulate your environment around you to the betterment of the human community. So we give, you know, it's just a thought, you know, but you know, we pray no one take it personal, but it's true. Just read and study the Bible. That's all we got to do. Everything else will just come. You know, be sure that it ain't nothing wrong with being zealous and trying to do too much, but let's be able and willing to recognize that much that we want to do could be, you know, could be those efforts could be correctly directed into what is most profitable for all in that. And we all want to help Wyndham Yagam and get this going, but we could all help him much more if we all become learned, because then he won't have to spend a day and night trying to teach what we should already know for ourselves. Then we would go forth and teach to all that which he spends all this time, you know, he spends most of his time doing, for the rest of us lack that ability. And so that would be the biggest help to our brother Yadun. And you know, we say this and we don't care really what anyone thinks, because I and I Wyndham Yadun taught I and I Christ. Ain't nobody taught I Christ before like he did, you know. Far, you know, I ain't the type of person that's trying to suck up to anyone out of whatever, but the truth be truth, ain't nobody in this world taught me Christ, and he did. And for that, and I'm eternally indebted to him in Christ, through Christ. And so my, you know, like, be sure that I know exactly what everyone is feeling when they want to give back to whom much has given. But we've got to be smart, and we got to be true in the way of which we give back. And we got to really think about how to give back and not set him back by being an obstacle. And so, you know, like, and it's true, you know, it's got to be said, ain't no person, you know, ain't none of our forefathers decorated in the kind of glory and array that Wyndham Yadam's been glory. Let me tell you that. And it's not because, oh, you just want to be, you know, you just want to get on his good side. I and I is in Christ's side, and that's enough to be on whoever is with Christ, and we know he's with Christ. That's enough to know for sure, for certain, that we be in his good side already. So we don't got to be saying nothing, but it's true. Ain't nobody ever in the history of humanity except for Christ Jesus and his imperial majesty declared the things that Wyndham Yadam Rasiadinos had declared. But we should take that forward and then do our part so that we can allow, you know, the progress to keep forward and but correctly and properly and orderly. So, but that had to have been said, because it's we speak truth. Ain't nobody upon the face of this planet other than the Father, Ali Selassie first, and his Son, Jesus Christ. Ain't nobody else ever been arrayed in half as much glory. I mean, you know, so this may sound like blasphemy or whatever, but we really don't care what anyone thinks except for that which is of Christ, and we be in Christ, so we know that which we say is true. Abraham didn't know half of what, you know. It's like when Christ Jesus, gospel of St. John, if I'm not mistaken, I think it's chapter 8. He says, I'm not sure if it's chapter 8, but it's the Gospel of John. You know, when Geta Jesus, he says, our Christ, and says, he says to the Pharisees and then that oppose him, he's like, Pharisees, I think they say something like, Abraham's our father. He's like, you know, all I did one thing, I did one work, and y'all want to kill me for it, you know? Y'all want to kill me. You want to kill me because I told you the truth. Abraham didn't do this. Abraham didn't even tell you the truth, and you want to kill me. So, kind of like, just to give an example of what we're not trying to say no one's better, we're just trying to say that ain't no other person aside from the Father and the Son been glory, been dressed with so much glory, and so we know exactly what ones feel, and how strong that will to wanna give back to whom hath taught us Christ Jesus, you know, the true Christ, you know, in his true humanity. Ain't nobody revealed so much like this man, and so let us be true in the manner and the form that we give back to him in love, in truth, and in spirit. And so, yeah, we're not even gonna okay, we're pretty sure what we were talking about was in the Gospel of St. John, so we're just gonna conclude with that. We give thanks for everyone for listening to the message. We hope that if I and I get mad, you know, only for a little while, but then, you know, come to truth with my and I self, you know, happens to us all the time. It's never easy to receive the truth, but, you know, if we're wrong, you know, bring forth the testimony, and we'll reason. Let us reason. But this, you know, this is the instruction of I and I, God and Father, you know. Study the Bible for yourselves and learn for yourself the ways to serve the Almighty. Inevitably, I and I would have found the way in serving I and I, brothers and sisters within the human community, in love, in true love. So, and love has to be hard at times, and so if we seem to be hard, which we're not, you know, considering the circumstances in the world, if some think that this message is a little too hard, well, put in consideration the thousands of people that are dying every day, the children that are starving to death, the mothers that are being mistreated, the women and children that are being persecuted, the wars that are being fought for no reason, the people that are you know, suffering in disease and ignorance, our brothers and sisters incarcerated, you know, living lives that they have no idea why they're even living. Put that in consideration, and then we'll come to realize that we're being soft in reality. You know, considering the world and the pain in which it's in. So, you know, take that in consideration whenever we receive potentially, you know, like a heartfelt message, you know, consider that, and then we'll know that Rastafari is being too soft. Maybe we got to be harder, but, you know, study and learn the Bible for yourself, and that is our suggestion as to how to contribute to the lineage of the Society of His Imperial Majesty. Shalom, Rastafari.